Nail Your Wave Day Trader reveals Wave's secrets. Nail Your Wave Day Trader reveals Wave's secrets. Good morning, good afternoon, good evening, bonjour, bonsoir, mes amis, guten morgen, guten tag, guten abend. For those of you who are new to us, we are the TSTW 24 traders, and our website for Elliott Wave Trading is www.24elliottwaves.com. The title of the video is An Elliott Wave A Day A Trader Reveals Wave's Secrets. In this tutorial, I want to share with traders a trading secret that a day trader can employ to make excellent wave count and excellent wave analysis. All right. We will be discussing what is an Elliott wave cycle, okay, and also the correlation between different time frame, the correlation between the wave patterns. For instance, between the 5-minute time frame and the 15-minute time frame. This is about wave trading secrets, how a day trader can apply the wave principle to make an excellent trading decision. All right, let's get started. Over the years, I have been observing the price, looking at the price itself, the number one indicators. I have been applying the wave principle, trying to understand, how one can apply the wave principle as a day a trader. When it comes to the wave principle, we are talking about how one can use the wave patterns to forecast the next price move. All right. So in this video, I want to show you exactly the thing that I have noticed when I was looking at the chart itself, when I was applying the wave principle. I have noticed a correlation between the 5-minute time frame and the 15-minute time frame, all right? So an Elliott wave cycle is formed of the motive waves and the corrective wave, all right? For traders that are new, I want to explain to you what is a motive wave. The motive wave is formed of the first wave, the second wave, the third wave, the fourth wave, and the fifth wave. So from the beginning of the first wave up to the end of the fifth wave, that's what we call the motive wave. It is also called the trending phase. So an Elliott wave cycle is formed of the trending phase and the corrective phase, all right? So the trending phase is the period between the first wave, second wave, third wave, fourth wave, and the fifth wave, all right? These are first wave, third wave, fifth wave are impulsive waves, all right? The corrective phase is formed of the correction that is starting at the beginning of that is starting at the end of the fifth wave. Repeat, the corrective phase is the price move from the beginning of the correction or at the end of the fifth wave. Let me clarify this to you. So the correction will start at the end of the motive wave, So the corrective phase is the price move that is starting at the end of the fifth wave. So we have a trending phase, first wave, second wave, third wave, fourth wave, and the fifth wave. So the trending phase or the motive wave has ended. And the fifth wave is also ending here. Then there is a correction that is beginning. That's what we call the corrective phase. Usually is formed of A, B, C, very often formed of three price moves. But there are more to the corrective waves. But generally speaking, when we are talking about the Elliott wave cycle, we are talking about 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 waves forming the motive wave plus the corrective phase, which is A, B, C. So from the beginning of the first wave up to the end of the corrective wave, okay, that's what we call the earlier wave cycle. So from here up to this point here, we have an earlier wave cycle that is completed. The same is true also in a downtrend when we have a first wave, second wave, third wave, fourth wave, and the fifth wave. This is, the motive wave, all right? So from the beginning of the first wave up to the end of the fifth wave, that's what we call the motive wave, followed by the correction formed of A, B, C. So from the beginning of the motive wave up to the end of the motive wave, okay? And then plus the A, B, C, we have an earlier wave cycle. So from here all the way up here, down to this point here, this is the end of the earlier wave cycle. So the earlier wave cycle is formed of the motive wave plus the corrective phase. So the cycle has started here, okay, at the beginning of the first wave, and has ended at the end of the corrective phase. But the trending phase has started here, but has ended at the end of the fifth wave. The same is true in the uptrend. The trending phase or the multi-wave has started from the beginning of the first wave and has ended at the end of the fifth wave. But the earlier wave cycle is not yet finished when the price is at the end of the fifth wave. Repeat, the end of the fifth wave is not the end of the earlier wave cycle. The earlier wave cycle is formed of the multi-wave plus the corrective wave. So beginning of the earlier wave cycle, end of the earlier wave cycle. Beginning of the earlier wave cycle in a downtrend, end of the earlier wave cycle. Okay, it makes sense. Now, let's get started with the wave secrets, talking about the correlation between the 5-minute time frame and the 15-minute time frame. The earlier wave, secret that I'm revealing here is very useful for, a trader. Okay, so if you are a day trader or somebody who is learning to day trade or somebody who starts applying the wave principle, it's very important to understand the earlier wave secrets. When we are on a five minute time frame, and we are counting the earlier wave. All right, suppose we are on the 5-minute time frame, okay? And then we count first wave, second wave, third wave, fourth wave, and the fifth wave on the 5-minute time frame, all right? Very often, you'll see that after the end of the five waves on the 5-minute time frame, you'll see something like a correction formed of ABC, like this, on the 5-minute time frame. So the point I want to clarify here, or the wave secret that I want you to understand here, is that when an earlier wave cycle is completed on a 5-minute time frame, that is corresponding now to the first wave and the second wave on the 15-minute time frame. So I know it's a little bit confusing, but it's an earlier wave secret. I'm going to explain it to you again. So you're on a 5-minute time frame, okay, my friend. You counted one first wave, second wave, third wave, fourth wave, and the fifth wave, all right? That first wave all the way to the end of the fifth wave on a 5-minute time frame will form, okay, the first wave on a 15-minute time frame. This is the first Elliott wave secret for a day a trader. So very often when you counted 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 wave on a 5-minute time frame, that's a motive wave. The motive wave on a 5-minute time frame very often, not always, but very often, we correspond to the first wave on a 15-minute time frame. Furthermore, the corrective wave on a 5-minute time frame, which is ABC, on a 5-minute time frame after the motive wave, very often, not always, we correspond to the second wave on a 15-minute time frame. Am I making myself clear? So We are talking about an Ehlers wave cycle on a 5-minute time frame. An Ehlers wave cycle is formed of the motive wave and the corrective wave, okay? But the motive wave on a 5-minute time frame is very often, not always, equal to the first wave on a 15-minute time frame. So we know that if we want to count the Ehlers wave, there are many steps that we follow. The general rule is that we have a consolidation, okay? And then we have a first wave break out of the consolidation zone. Second wave, try to retest the top of the consolidation, followed by the third wave, okay? And then the fourth wave, all right? And then the fifth wave. Now, if you don't understand this, you need to subscribe to 24 Elliott Wave YouTube channel, okay? How to count Ehlers wave. So on a 5-minute time frame, we can 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 wave, beginning of a trend, all right? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 wave, that's a multi-wave. Very often, that multi-wave on a 5-minute time frame will correspond to the first wave on a 15-minute chart. If there is a trend, all right? Now, the ABCD correction on a 5-minute time frame will correspond to the second wave on a 50-minute chart. This is the area wave, the first area wave secret for a day a trader. Now, if you have any question, please feel free to put in the comment section and I will get back to you, okay? All right? If you're going to ask a question, ask a clear-cut question, get to the point, and I will give you a clear-cut answer, okay? All right? So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 wave, multi-wave on the 5-minute time frame, very often will correspond to the first wave on the 15-minute time frame. The ABC correction on the 5-minute time frame will correspond to the second wave on the 15-minute time frame. So an Ehlers wave cycle on a 5-minute time frame very often will correspond to the first wave and the second wave on a 15-minute time frame. It makes sense? This is the first Ehlers wave secret. The second Ehlers wave secret, according to my observations, okay, when we are counting Ehlers wave on a 15-minute time frame. Now, remember, the first time we start counting wave, we are counting the Ehlers wave on a 5-minute time frame. And we have noticed a correlation between a 5-minute time frame and a 15-minute time frame, okay? Now, for the second Ehlers wave secret, we are counting the Ehlers waves on a 15-minute time frame. Don't get confused. So now, we are not on a 5-minute time frame anymore, we are on a 15-minute time frame, starting to count Ehlers wave. So on a 15 time frame, we count first wave, second wave, third wave, fourth wave, and a fifth wave, followed by A, B, C. So this is an Ehlers wave cycle on a 15-minute time frame. According to my observation, this is the second Ehlers wave secret. We have noticed that the multi-wave on a 15-minute time frame very often will correspond to the first Ehlers wave on a 2-hour chart. Now, let me say this again. We have noticed that the first wave, second wave, third wave, fourth wave, and the fifth wave, which is forming the multi-wave on a 15-minute time frame, very often will correspond to the first wave on a 2-hour time frame. So, first wave, second wave, third wave, fourth wave, and fifth wave on a 15-minute time frame very often will correspond to a multi-wave on a 2-hour time frame. So first wave on a 2-hour time frame is very often the multi-wave on a 15-minute time frame. The corrective phase on a 50-minute time frame very often will correspond to the second wave on a two-hour time frame. This is the second Elliott wave, a secret for a day a trader. Am I making myself clear? So you on a 50-minute time frame, you see a consolidation, or you see a cycle point, or an Elliott wave cycle is completed, okay? And then this is about how to count Elliott wave. That's why I say to you, subscribe to 24 Elliott Wave YouTube channel, okay? Or go to www.24elliottwave.com and click on how to wave counts guidelines, okay? So you're on a 50-minute time frame. You know how to, a trend is starting. You know how to count area wave. You know how to follow the area wave guidelines, okay? So you see the first wave, second wave, third wave, fourth wave, and the fifth wave on a 15-minute time frame, okay? From the first wave to the 15, from the first wave to the fifth wave on the 15-minute time frame, we have a multi-wave. The multi-wave on the 15-minute time frame very often will correspond to the first wave on the 2 hour time frame. Now, if you are a new trader, I recommend that you subscribe to 24 Elliott Wave YouTube channel or to our 24 Elliott Wave website so you may start learning about Elliott Wave count. Now, what we are discussing here, some traders may find it a bit difficult, but I'm trying my best to speak a bit slowly so you may understand what I'm saying here. This is about the higher degree and the lower degree, the correlation, the fractal pattern of the wave principle. All right, so we are talking about the 5 minute time frame and a 50-minute time frame. The multi-wave on the 5 minute time frame very often will correspond to an impulsive wave on a 50-minute time frame. Very often, the multi-wave and the corrective phase on the 5-minute time frame will correspond to the first wave and the second wave on the 50-minute time frame. But the point I want you to remember is that the multi-wave on the 50-minute time frame will correspond to an impulsive wave on the 50-minute time frame. The second Elliott wave secret, we are saying that when we count the first wave, second wave, third wave, fourth wave, and fifth wave on the 50-minute time frame, that's a multi-wave. A multi-wave on a 50-minute time frame very often will correspond to an impulsive wave on the 2 hour time frame. All right? A corrective wave on a 50-minute time frame very often, okay, will correspond to a corrective wave on the 2 hour time frame. So, for the illustration of the correlation between the 50-minute time frame and the 2 hour time frame, so we count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 waves that may correspond to an impulsive wave. That's the general rule, may correspond to an impulsive wave on the 2 hour chart. But very often you see that that's the first wave. If you are just starting to count the wave, so if you just start counting wave, this is very important, all right? Cycle point, consolidation on a 50-minute chart, you can 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 wave. That 5 wave very often will correspond to the first wave on the 2 hour time frame. Now, the correction that will follow that multi-wave, WABC, very often will correspond to the second wave on the 2 hour chart. But the general rule that you need to grasp is that a multi-wave on a 50-minute time frame very often will correspond to an impulsive wave on the 2 hour time frame. This is the second Elliott wave secret for a day a trader. All right? The third Elliott wave secret, my friend, stay tuned with us, okay? Stay tuned. Is that when we are now on the hourly time frame, okay? So we start counting first on the 5 minute time frame. And then we see that there's a correlation between a 5 minute and a 50-minute time frame, talking about the higher degree and the lower degree, okay? And then we start counting wave on a 50-minute time frame, and we notice that there is a correlation between a 50-minute time frame and a 2 hour time frame, talking about the area wave fractal, the higher degree, and the lower degree, okay? Now, the third area wave secrets, okay, talking about an area wave day trader, reveals a wave secret. The third area wave secret is that when we start counting the area wave on the hourly time frame, okay, we count first wave, okay, first wave, second wave, third wave, fourth wave, and the fifth wave on the hourly time frame. From the beginning of the first wave to the end of the fifth wave, we have what we call a motive wave. The motive wave on the hourly time frame very often will correspond to an impulsive wave on the daily chart. There is a correlation between the hourly time frame and the daily time frame. Talking about the area wave fractal, the correlation between the hourly wave patterns and the daily chart wave pattern. Furthermore, the ABC correlation on the hourly time frame very often, not always, will correspond to a corrective wave on a daily time frame. All right? So there is a correlation between the wave pattern on the hourly time frame and a wave pattern on a daily time frame. But the daily time frame is a higher degree in relation to the hourly time frame. A motive wave on the hourly time frame is an impulsive wave on a daily time frame. A corrective phase on the hourly time frame is very often, okay, a corrective wave on a daily time frame. Does it make sense? All right, if you have any question, please feel free to put it below in the comment section and I will get back to you. Please ask a specific question and I will give you a specific answer, okay? All right, it makes sense? So to summarize this video, when we are counting area wave, so I want you to understand this clearly, all right? You start in counting wave, how to count wave. So if you do not know how to count wave, I recommend that you check our website, 24aliawave.com. Click on wave count, okay, area wave guidelines, okay? Very, very important, okay? Very, very important. And also click on how to count wave. Now, before we start counting wave, there are things that we look for, all right? One example is that we have a pattern like this, a consolidation, a price consolidating fast, and then we see the first wave, the first area wave, is the wave that usually breaks out of the consolidation zone, followed by a pullback, which is the second wave. So if, for instance, my friend, London is open or New York is open, and then you see a consolidation that is taking place, okay? All right? Or Hong Kong is open, and then you see a consolidation that was taking place. As the consolidation was taking place, suddenly you see a breakout. You label it, okay, first wave, followed by, okay, a pullback that will not cancel the first wave, and then you have the second wave, and so on, third wave, fourth wave, and the fifth wave. If you're on a 5-minute time frame, just remember that if you count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 waves on a 5-minute time frame, that usually will correspond to a single motive wave on the 15-minute time frame. That's why I highlight here with the pink line here. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 on the 5-minute time frame will correspond to a motive wave on a 15-minute time frame. On the other hand, if you see ABC like this, okay, a corrective phase divided ABC on a 5-minute time frame, very often that will correspond to a corrective wave on a 15-minute time frame. There is a correlation between the 5-minute time frame and the 15-minute time frame. There are more to this. So if there is something that is a bit confusing to you, please put in the comment section, because some traders may not clearly understand what we are discussing here. We are talking about the area wave fractal patterns. Okay, it's a little bit advanced area wave trading, the fractal nature of the wave principles. A wave of a higher degree can be subdivided on a lower degree into, okay, a manner waves. Okay, it makes sense? We have noted the same thing. There is a correlation between the motive wave on a 15-minute time frame and a 2-hour time frame. So if we count first wave, second wave, third wave, fourth wave, fifth wave, okay, on a 50-minute time frame is likely to correspond to an impulsive wave on a two-hour time frame. So what is an impulsive wave? So if you are very, very new trader, you have a lot to learn again. The multi waves are the waves that are in the direction of the trend. Okay, so we say that the multi wave is the trending phase. So any wave that is going in the direction of the trend is a multi wave. For example, the first wave is a multi wave, all right? The third wave is a multi wave, and the fifth wave is a multi wave. Because during the trending phase, which is the multi wave, okay, we have the first wave that is going in the direction of the trend, but the second wave is not going in the direction of the trend. The third wave is also going in the direction of the trend, but the fourth wave is not going in the direction of the trend. The fifth wave is going to in the direction of the trend. So all the waves that are going in the direction of the trend are called motive waves. So first wave, third wave, and the fifth wave are motive wave. But again, don't get confused. Apart from that, we also call first wave, second wave, third wave, fourth wave, and fifth wave. From here, all the way here, we call it also the multi-wave. So don't get confused. Don't get confused, okay? This is also a multi-wave. From the beginning of the first wave to the end of the fifth wave is also called multi-wave. So a multi-wave on the 50-minute time frame will correspond very often, not always, to an impulsive wave on the two-hour time frame. A corrective phase on a 50-minute time frame will correspond to a corrective wave on a two-hour time frame. The same verification is also true on the hourly time frame. When we counted the first wave, second wave, third wave, fourth wave, fifth wave on the hourly time frame, we will notice that this is a multi-wave. The multi-wave on the hourly time frame very often will correspond to an impulsive wave on a daily time frame, on a daily chart. A corrective phase on the hourly time frame will correspond to a corrective wave on a daily chart. This is about an annual wave day trader reveals a wave a secret. In the next video, we will be talking about a swing trader, okay, reveals, okay, effective annual wave secrets. All right? I hope you have learned something for this video also, and will put into use, okay, to make excellent wave count, wave analysis, okay, and also excellent trading decision. This is about, okay, wave secrets. If you like this video, please give us the thumbs up. If you dislike this video, please give us the thumbs down, but put a comment below why you disagree with us, okay? If you love, okay, our videos, feel free, okay, to subscribe to our YouTube channel, okay? If you love this video, feel free to share it on Google+, on Twitter, and also on Facebook. Until the next time, enjoy yourself and be very happy. We are the TSTW24 Trader. Talking about an annual wave day trader reveals waves secrets. Speak to you soon.